Hey guys, it's Grant jumping in to remind you there's still 1 week left to win this Galaxy S9 Plus smartphone. It could be yours. There's a link down in the description to get your name on the list to qualify. Best of luck, and we'll see you around.
Hey guys, I am Nate. We are at the Dome once again with another experiment using molten salt. We're going to see what happens if you combine molten salt with eggs in a couple of different ways. We'll see what happens if we pour molten salt onto an egg. We'll probably try dropping a whole egg into our crucible full of molten salt. And then I think we'll try pouring some molten salt onto our frying pan and then seeing if we can fry an egg on that salt. We have all of our equipment and supplies and eggs. Let's fire up the furnace. Our salt is just about melted, so let's put some eggs into our little pot here. I'm gonna try something a little odd. I'm gonna try having two cracked eggs and two whole eggs, and I'm just gonna pour the salt on top, and that way we'll be able to see the effect on both of those at once.
Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Woo! Something cracked immediately. I'm not sure what that was. Just right as I poured it into the pot, something made a cracking noise, and I assume that was something from the moisture in the eggs themselves.
Tell you what, that does not smell really great.
That eggshell is still in place. This eggshell is partially not in place. It's not exactly cooked through, but it's still very hot, so of course things could still be cooking in there. I'm gonna crack this part of the shell open. Still uncooked inside there. I'm gonna try and dump the whole thing out, salt and eggs, onto our frying pan here. That worked pretty good. So we've got all of our salt right here. We've got some, overcooked egg right here. In this part, it looks like we've got some fairly nicely cooked egg mixed with raw egg. Well, let's move on to the next thing. All right, now we're gonna drop an egg into the molten salt in the crucible and quickly back away, because I don't know what's gonna happen. 3, 2, 1.
Wow! Let's do another one.
3, 2, 1.
I guess it had cooled down a little bit. Oh, that smells so bad.
Well, there's our egg already partially cooked through. The first egg exploded violently. The second egg, not so much.
So our egg shell kind of got coated in some of the melted salt. Definitely stuck to it a little bit. It's kind of gross. So this is the shell with the salt stuck to it. This is the actual egg, which burned in parts and is raw in parts. I'm just gonna squish it. It's a step beyond eggs over easy right there. So now I've got a final batch of salt heating up in the furnace. I'm gonna pour that right onto our frying pan, and then I'm gonna try and crack an egg onto that and see if I can cook the egg, get a nice fried egg, maybe even try and flip it over in the pan.
That looks so freaking awesome. Glowing orange liquid.
All right, let's let that salt cool down just a bit, because I'm not trying to destroy these eggs. I do want a hot surface, but I want to actually cook them and possibly eat one. So I think as long as it's still glowing orange, it's probably too hot.
I'm gonna try cracking one right there. Seems like a good spot. One more.
Well, it is spilling off the side a little bit, but we've got some nice cooked looking egg at the bottom. I'm just not sure if there'll be enough heat to cook all the way through for me to try and really get this egg cooked. I also don't know anything about the non-stick properties of salt, so this could be very stuck or not at all stuck. Actually seems to come off pretty easily. Not holding itself together very well though. I don't know if that piece is hot, so it might not be doing anything to cook it. It might just be resting on it. This is definitely starting to get cooked through. Let's see if I can flip this egg over. I don't think I'll be able to smoothly get under it, so it's gonna get a little torn up as I try. My salt might be cooling down a little too much. This one's just completely falling apart, so I don't think I can really flip anything. That yolk isn't even a little bit cooked. Well, this portion of the egg looks like it has cooked. Not really a good looking cooked egg, but it's something. Cheers. Tastes like fried egg. It's actually pretty good. Very salty. I might have added too much salt because it might have already been salty. Didn't really test that. Let's try a bit that I didn't get much salt on. I think it did. I think it picked up some of the salt. Using molten salt to cook eggs in a few different varieties. We tried pouring molten salt into a pot that had some cracked eggs and some uncracked eggs in it. Something cracked the moment I poured the salt into that. I'm not sure what that was. Maybe just one of the shells breaking open. Maybe that was some steam forming. Hard to really tell. I really liked the look of the glowing orange molten salt surrounding the eggs. That was pretty freaking cool. We then tried dropping a whole egg into our crucible full of molten salt. And the first one we did, I dropped it in and immediately it exploded and kind of went flying out of the crucible. That was also really cool. I dropped another egg into there after the first one popped out. It didn't pop, it didn't really crack much, but it did just sit in there and burn quite a bit. Then I tried pouring out the molten salt onto a frying pan and cracking a couple of eggs onto the salt after it had solidified to try and cook the eggs right on the salt. And overall, even though this is the best of the three methods for using salt to cook an egg, it's really not a good plan. You don't get anywhere very useful. If you've got any ideas of things that you want to see us do with molten salt, let us know down in the comments. And if we use your idea, we will send you $25.
Hey, what's up guys? It's Grant here with a brand new Galaxy S9 Plus smartphone that I'm giving away to one of you for subscriber appreciation. I've got a link down in the description so you can get your name on the list and qualify to win.